Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, A Guide for Nursing Students. Today we will discuss fetal circulation.
So from the name itself we can understand that it is the blood circulation in the fetus. So what is fetus? Fetus is an unborn baby, right? That is before birth or in the intrauterine life, how the circulation of fetus. So that we will discuss today. Before dealing with fetal circulation, just we will revise the circulation after birth. Right atrium, this is right ventricle, this is left atrium, this is left ventricle, these are pulmonary veins, this is pulmonary artery, and this is aorta. So here from the inferior vena cava and superior vena cava, that is from whole part of the body, it will be collecting the deoxygenated blood. And this deoxygenated blood, it enters into the right atrium of the heart. So from the right atrium, what will happen? Through tricuspid valve, it enters into the right ventricle. Both right atrium and right ventricle, it is filled with the deoxygenated blood. After entering into the right ventricle, that blood enters into the pulmonary artery. Then that pulmonary artery entering into the lungs. Okay, so from that lungs, what will happen means their blood get highly oxygenated, and that oxygenated blood enters into the pulmonary vein. So normally in our body, artery will be carrying oxygenated blood and vein will be carrying deoxygenated blood, but in the cardiac circulation, in the pulmonary artery will be carrying deoxygenated blood and pulmonary vein will be carrying oxygenated blood. Same in fetal circulation also, umbilical artery will carry deoxygenated blood and umbilical vein will carry oxygenated blood. That is opposite to the normal circulation. So here pulmonary vein carries oxygenated blood from the lungs and it enters into the left atrium, and from the left atrium that blood enters into the left ventricle through bicuspid valve or mitral valve. Okay, so here it is labeled with red color. Why? Means it is completely pure blood. Right part of the heart, it is completely filled with the deoxygenated blood. Then from the left ventricle, what will happen? That blood enters into the arch of aorta, right? So in the arch of aorta, ascending aorta is also there and descending aorta also there. Ascending aorta means it will be supplying towards the upper part of the body, like brain, head, neck, upper extremities. Blood enters into the arch of aorta. More amount of blood, it will be going to the upper arch of aorta, and some amount of blood, it will be going towards the descending aorta. Complete body will get oxygenated blood. Okay, so this is a normal circulation. Main thing you should remember, this right part of the heart, it is filled with the deoxygenated blood. Left side is filled with the completely pure oxygenated blood.
Next we will see the characteristics of fetal circulation. So placenta is a main source of oxygen for the fetus. As we all know that fetal lungs are not completely developed, so here fetus is completely depends upon placenta. Okay, placenta is the source of oxygen for the fetus. That is first characteristic. Second one is fetal lungs receives less than 1% of the blood volume. So the fetal lungs are not completely matured, that's why it needs only less amount of blood volume. Next one is lungs will not exchange gases because it is not developed. Okay, so here the function of lungs will be performed by placenta. Then right atrium of the fetal heart is a chamber with the highest oxygen concentration, but in adult circulation a high amount of oxygenated blood we can see in the left atrium. These are the characteristics. Next, we'll see the special structures of fetal circulation. We'll see the structures of fetal circulation. Okay, so here you can see this red color blood vessel, that is umbilical vein. So that is one special structure in fetal circulation. Next special structure is umbilical arteries. So here in the fetal circulation, there are mainly two umbilical arteries are there and one umbilical vein is there. So here you can see umbilical arteries. You can see here one path, this is ductus venosus. This is another special structure. And next you can see here in this part, this is right atrium, this is left atrium, this is right ventricle and this is left ventricle. Between right atrium and left atrium we can see a opening or shunt, that is known as foramen ovale. Okay, the next special structure is ductus arteriosus. Okay, so one by one we will discuss. First one is umbilical vein. So umbilical vein carries oxygen and nutrients to the fetus. That is, from the placenta, it carries oxygen and nutrients to the fetus. That is a feature of umbilical vein. Next, umbilical artery. So umbilical artery carries deoxygenated blood and waste products from the fetus. That is, from the fetal body, whatever waste materials or whatever the deoxygenated or carbon dioxide and all, it will be carried towards the placenta. Okay. So next, ductus venosus. So ductus venosus means it's a vein to vein connection, that's why it is known as venosus. Okay, so it shunts blood from the umbilical vein to the inferior vena cava by passing the liver and organs of digestion. That means it will be shunts the blood from umbilical vein to the inferior vena cava. It will be connecting the inferior vena cava and umbilical vein. And next is foramen ovale. Foramen ovale is the connection of shunt between left atrium and right atrium. Okay. Next, ductus arteriosus. So ductus arteriosus means it's a connection between artery to artery. What are those arteries? Means pulmonary artery to the aorta. So it will be shunts blood from pulmonary artery to the aorta by passing the lungs. So normally in adult circulation, this blood will be going through pulmonary vein to the left atrium, then left ventricle, then to the aorta. But here directly it will be entering into the aorta. These are the structures of fetal circulation. So next we'll discuss how the blood will be circulating in the fetal body. Here we can see the fetal circulation. Okay, so in the fetal circulation, the starting point is placenta. That means we know that placenta, it is attached to the uterine wall of the mother, and here this is placenta. Okay, so from the placenta, this umbilical cord is connected to the fetus, and here you can see from the placenta red color blood vessel, that is umbilical vein, because it is carrying oxygenated blood. Okay, and here in the blue colored blood vessel, two blood vessels we can see, that is umbilical arteries. So umbilical arteries carries deoxygenated blood, that is from the fetus. So here from the placenta, this umbilical vein, it will be carrying oxygenated blood and it will be moving towards the fetus through umbilical cord, and it enters into the fetal body at the level of umbilicus. So then what will happen means it enters. Here you can see the fetal liver. So this umbilical vein, it will be entering into the liver. It will be forming into branches. Okay, so umbilical vein carries oxygenated blood from the placenta. Oxygenated blood means nutrients, everything, it will be there. Okay, it will be entering into the fetal body through umbilicus. After entering into the fetal body, here we can see fetal body means it will be running towards the liver. So this is liver, and in the liver it will be dividing into branches. Okay, so here branches will be forming. So after forming this branches, here you can see one blue colored blood vessel, that is portal vein. Portal vein means venous drainage from the liver, right? So here this umbilical vein carries oxygenated blood and portal vein carries deoxygenated blood. Okay, so here when it will be connecting with this umbilical vein, a small portion of blood will mix with this pure blood. Okay, but there is no change in the quality, because this is umbilical vein is carrying 100% oxygenated blood. Okay, here the small portion will mix. After that, what will happen means its branches, it will be going like this way. Then here you can see this blue colored vessel. This is known as inferior vena cava. And here a small connection is there, already we discussed, that is shunt. Okay, so that is ductus venosus. See, here this is ductus venosus. Okay, so this umbilical vein, through ductus venosus, it will be connecting to the inferior vena cava. Okay, so here also a small portion of blood mixing will occur. So after that, what will happen means, through this inferior vena cava, this umbilical vein, through inferior vena cava, it will be connecting towards the heart. Okay, and it enters into the right atrium. This is right atrium of heart, and this is left atrium of heart, and this is right ventricle, and this is left ventricle. Okay, so in the right atrium, it is filled with the high oxygenated blood in fetal circulation, but in adult circulation or after birth, in the right atrium it is filled with the deoxygenated blood. In fetal circulation, this right atrium is filled with 100% oxygenated blood. Okay, so after entering into the right atrium, here two directions are there. Okay, so that is from right atrium to left atrium. Here one connection is there, that is foramen ovale. So from here right atrium, through this connection some amount of blood will go to left atrium and some amount of blood will go to right ventricle. Okay, so already we have discussed the adult circulation, what is the difference. Now you can understand. So here from the right atrium, 75% of highly oxygenated blood will be moving from right atrium to left atrium through foramen ovale. Then we can see from this left atrium, pure blood or 75% oxygenated blood move from left atrium to left ventricle through mitral valve. Here mitral valve or bicuspid valve is there. So through that mitral valve, it will be going towards a left ventricle. Okay, so during ventricular systole, what will happen? Pure blood moving towards arch of aorta. Here you can see this is arch of aorta. So then from the arch of aorta, its branches, it will be supplying this pure blood towards the brain, neck, head and to the heart. So that is about this 75% oxygenated blood. Okay, so again next we'll come here in the right atrium. So from here only 75% blood only it supplied, 25% is remaining here. Remaining 25% of blood, it will be moving from this right atrium to right ventricle through tricuspid valve. Okay, so from here right atrium to right ventricle it will be moving, then through pulmonary trunk or pulmonary artery. Okay, through pulmonary artery that blood will be moving, its color is pink color. That means in the blood only 25% of oxygen is present, that's why. Okay, it is not completely pure blood. Okay, so it will be moving through pulmonary trunk. Then through pulmonary trunk two ways are there. That is, through this pulmonary artery, a small amount, that is 1% of blood, it will be moving towards lungs. In fetal life, the lungs are not mature. So here 1% of blood, it will be going towards for the functioning or for development of this lungs. Okay, then from here, major portion of blood will be entering into the descending art. Through here one connection is there, that is ductus arteriosus. So through this connection it will be entering into the descending arch of aorta. So this is ascending arch, this is descending arch towards lower side. This descending aorta, it will be supplying towards the lower part of the body, especially it will be forming into internal iliac artery, hypogastric artery, and finally this will be leaving as umbilical arteries. That blood, it is less oxygenated, and these umbilical arteries finally it enters into the placenta. So this deoxygenated blood leaves the body by the way of two umbilical arteries to reach the placenta, where it is oxygenated and gets ready for recirculation. So this is about fetal circulation. Thank you.